We all know it. Walked it every day. But none of them were like these. The world's most dangerous ways to school. Freezing. Climbing for hours. Bailing non-stop, all for the chance of a better life. Spectacular and sometimes simply beautiful. The world's most dangerous ways to school. The river has changed overnight. Yesterday, it was still a safe place to cross. Now, it poses a potential hazard for 10-year-old Tuguldur and his horse. The constant thawing and refreezing causes the ice to reshape itself. Can Tuguldur trust the ice? Will the ice hold his weight? Just like the other Mongolian nomad children in the valley, Tuguldur must cross the river to get to school in Tunkhel. On the icy way there, the children learn valuable life lessons. The nomad girl Delgertsetseg must also travel through the biting cold.
When spring comes, everything is better. The snow melts and everything is green.
The school in the village, a warm haven.
Sometimes I'm afraid that the horse will buck and start running.
The nomad children in Mongolia. Theirs is one of the most dangerous ways to school in the world. Winter on the Mongolian steppe. A long and difficult time for nomadic Mongolians and their cattle. Temperatures drop to minus 50 degrees Celsius. Far away from settlements, the milder valleys serve as the winter quarters for the nomads. The morning of the last day of school before the holidays in February. It's 6 o'clock. 12-year-old Delgertsetseg wishes it was already Tsagansa, or White Moon, the Mongolian Lunar New Year celebration. Then she could stay in bed a little bit longer and not have to face the cold darkness on the way to school. Outside the yurt this morning, it's minus 30 degrees Celsius. That's why Delgertsetseg puts on very thick undergarments under her school uniform.
First, I put on two pairs of tights, and over those, my sweatpants. Finally, my black pants.
Due to the bitter cold, her father, Dava, brought his motorcycle into the yurt overnight. The hard frost weakens the battery and thickens the engine oil. Everything and everyone here has to struggle to get moving.
Come here. I'll do that.
School starts at 8 o'clock.
First, I have math, literature, and then music. After that, biology and chess lessons. PE is last. My favorite subject is chess.
Compulsory education also applies to the nomad children. Her mother, Aria, has prepared a small breakfast of tea and biscuits. Time is short. Latecomers are given extra exercises as a penalty.
If I'm late or not wearing my uniform, then I have to erase the black marks made from shoes on the floor.
Shortly after 7 o'clock, it's time to go out into the cold. Five kilometers separate her home from the school. Five quite special kilometers. Their constant companions are the icy wind and the danger of skidding off the road. At the beginning of their journey, her 44-year-old father, Dava, must maneuver the bike through deep ruts in the snow, all the while keeping his balance.
It's cold. It really is. And you start to freeze really quickly. And it is very, very icy. If you do not drive slowly, it is very dangerous. You slip faster than you can imagine. Driving slowly helps, and eventually, at some point, you learn how to do so.
After 400 meters, Deva and his daughter reach their road, a snow-covered trail that has frozen overnight. They will travel on it into the village. There are 2 more kilometers until they reach the narrow part in the valley. That's where father and daughter must cross the dangerous river. Upriver, 5 kilometers from Delgertsetseg's home, it's now time for breakfast. The younger children, like 10-year-old Tuguldur, only have school in the afternoon.
Where's daddy?
He's out.
My son, have you washed your hands?
Tuguldur's mother, Selenge, has prepared plenty of buts for the new year. The steamed dumplings filled with meat are Tuguldur's and his 5-year-old sister's Michelle's favorite. They're served with salted milk tea. Michelle doesn't go to school yet. Meanwhile, Delgertsetseg and her father have traveled half the distance. The wind is icy, making the temperature feel like minus 45 degrees Celsius.
Oh, the black dog again.
And then suddenly, a wild dog appears. The animal tries to snap at their heels, but it can't keep up with the motorcycle. After that scare, the girl's dangerous way to school is not over yet. Her father, Dava, is now heading for the frozen river. Here's where they have to cross. The spot they always use to get over to the other side of the river has been covered with snow now for a few days. Dava cannot exactly see how thick the ice is under the layer of snow. He relies on his experience and observations of the weather. It's 20 meters to get to the other shore. They've done it. The girl hopes it was the last time this winter.
When spring comes, everything is better. The snow melts and everything is green.
The town of Tunkhel in northern Mongolia awakes with the first rays of the sun. Delgertsetseg is shivering by the time the half-hour's ride is over. But she's almost there. Only a few hundred meters, again through the ruts in the road. Delgertsetseg's school friends, whose parents are not nomads, have a better life. They live in the village, and their way to school is short and not so dangerous. A final obstacle awaits Delgertsetseg, the railroad crossing. School is on the other side. Delgertsetseg and her father arrive shortly before 8.
Careful crossing the tracks.
Bye.
Motorcycles are not allowed in town in the winter months because of the heightened risk of accidents. Therefore, her father, Dava, drops his daughter off at the railway crossing right outside of town. The girl must cross the tracks alone because school is on the other side, as are the police. The nomad can hardly afford a ticket.
It is unfortunate. From the 1st of October, it is forbidden to drive a motorbike into the villages until, I think, April 10th. This law really should be revoked here on the countryside.
Delgertsetseg makes it to school on time. For a nomad girl who lives far away from the village, the school is also a social event. Together with her sixth grade classmates, she uses every free minute to play the cap stork game, for example.
So, make a stork? Make a cap, cap, stork.
The teacher is here.
Delgertsetseg must now do a lot of reading and writing, but she's looking forward to her favorite subject, chess. Since there are 530 students from the village and its surroundings, and not all fit into the 15 classrooms at once, the school system is divided into morning and afternoon classes. This way, while the older ones are in class, the younger students are not forced to face the early cold getting to school. But the sun's warmth brings a new danger. Around 11 o'clock, Tuguldur lets the cows out of the barn and drives them to the river. Barn and house are between two rivers, so Tuguldur knows the hazardous change when the hard ice starts slowly melting in the warm sun. For the animals, it's a blessing, because they can finally quench their thirst in places where they would otherwise only encounter ice. But for Tuguldur, the softened ice is dangerous. He too must cross the river later, and he rides to school on horseback. Tuguldur goes back to the house and changes his clothes. His father has already saddled Brownie, named after the color of its coat.
If anything like leaves or a plastic bag is carried up by the wind, or anything hanging in the tree starts to rustle, the horse starts to buck. When I see such a thing in the distance, I make a big circle around it. But sometimes the horse gets spooked, and then it's dangerous.
His father, Murun, also has a car. But he only uses it during blizzards and when temperatures are below minus 20 degrees Celsius. Gasoline is expensive. Murun makes a small fire under the engine.
I warm up the engine oil. Then, when I turn the ignition, the car starts up immediately. That's protected. Here on the sides, you can see it well. This is very well protected from below here. And then, above it, you can see the engine.
Today, Murun must take the grandfather into town to run errands for the New Year feast. And Tuguldur? Shortly after 11, the temperatures are just below 0 degrees Celsius. The boy is getting ready for school. His father is aware of the risks, but still lets the small child ride the 10-kilometer route to school alone. Even though Tuguldur sometimes has problems with Brownie.
When it runs, when the horse is really galloping, it's very hard for me to take the reins and bring it to halt. Sometimes I can't do it. When it really gets going, I can't control it.
The boy can't even get up on the horse without help.
Do not gallop. And stay away from the street and cars.
Bye.
Take care, my son. I warn him often about riding too fast, so be careful on the ice and get off the road and keep his distance when there are cars. Never come down off the horse, I tell him always. That's dangerous.
Just a few hundred meters away from the family home, the road is steep. Tuguldur faces his first challenge. To stay away from the slippery road, he leads Brownie down in deeper snow. The first danger is behind him, but Tuguldur can already feel just how slippery the road is today. An hour-long ride along the river valley lies ahead of the nomadic boy. The next place where Tuguldur must be vigilant is a small larch forest. The boy, who is not yet quite steady in the saddle, is now on his own.
If I should ever fall off the horse, I will need to find an elevated place and try to jump from there onto the horse. But that should never really happen.
Low-hanging branches could knock him off the horse. He has to be careful and duck when needed. Once he is out of the forest, he is faced with the greatest challenge. At the base of the wide valley, the river awaits him. At school in Tunkhel, the second to last hour begins, and the classes change rooms. Chess class now begins. Delgertsetseg has been looking forward to this the entire morning. From sixth grade on, the children have chess as a school subject. After only half a year, Delgertsetseg is already very good, the fourth best in her class. A short refresher in game theory, and the game finally starts. White begins. Delgertsetseg wants to become a chess teacher one day.
It's my turn now.
The kids already understand that chess promotes intelligence and is a game of intrigue. But mostly, they just like to play, so they enjoy the chess lessons. They play together, win, and experience success. Victories generate emotions, and they are proud. In our school, chess is always one of the favorite subjects. Of course, they also love physical education. But chess is at least just as popular. Students want to play on the board against each other. Sir, me. They always want to play. The nomad girl Delgertsetseg wins. It's 12:30. As the girl's time in school comes to an end for the day, clouds gather over the steppe. The wind gains strength, and it starts getting colder again. Tuguldur has mastered 2/3 of the way, but now he faces the real danger. The river. The ice is meters thick, but not everywhere.
Could it break here? The horse is probably too heavy. Better not.
Tuguldur searches for a safe place where he and his horse can cross the ice.
Sometimes there are very slippery sections or some with very little snow. In such places, the horse always slides. Those are not good places to go over.
At this spot, the temperature fluctuations have transformed the surface of the river into black ice, too slippery for a hooved animal. There is no way to cross here. Tuguldur tries his luck a few hundred yards away. He's already been on the road now for 45 minutes. A 10-year-old alone, left to his own devices, heading to school on a horse. This is quite normal for Tuguldur's parents and part of their nomadic culture, which also includes the ability to survive in nature. Although they live in a solid house, they still see themselves as nomads.
That they take their lives into their own hands, this we want to give to our children. This includes a good education. We teach them on the countryside to have more independence so they can live as nomads here later. You should be able to live here, but at the same time be able to earn a living in the city.
After a 5-minute detour, Tuguldur has found a spot where he wants to try it. A gaping crack in the middle of the river. Actually a sign that thick sheets of ice have collided together.
Now just do not fall down. When horses get scared, they simply run off. Then you have to pull the reins tightly to bring them into a halt. Sometimes when it starts running suddenly, I also get terribly frightened. I'm terrified of sudden, quick movements.
Tuguldur scrutinizes the ice. He decides to try it. Brownie shies away from the danger. Tuguldur must show no fear now. The horse would sense any uncertainty. They get closer to the gap. And the horse obeys, overcoming its fear. Just like Tuguldur, who has also overcome his fear. The student reaches the other side safely. Classes are over for the morning children. Out onto the playground. The last few minutes that Delgertsetseg can enjoy with her school friends and is allowed to be a child before her father comes to pick her up. She loves to play the chain game, in which the children form two teams and take turns trying to break a link in the opponent's chain. Whoever doesn't make it must stay. Whoever makes it gets to take one of the opponents with them.
Go! Let him in! Now shoot, shoot!
And then, a short brawl. Delgertsetseg is in the midst of it all.
One of them hit me on the hand, so I went to him and hit him back.
Tuguldur hurries. The detour by the river has cost him time. He reaches Tunkhel 15 minutes before the start of the afternoon classes. He can't tie the horse up at school. The school director doesn't allow it. But Tuguldur's family have friends in town. He leaves the horse in the courtyard of a garage until school is over. Brownie will wait until school is over. From here, it's only a few meters walk to school. The afternoon students line up at the entrance to the school. They would also get extra work for tardiness. Tuguldur is on time. On the way, he's met friends. They have to take a math test in the first hour. By 1 o'clock, the young students are allowed to enter the warm building as the older ones head home. Here, the two nomad children meet each other.
What subjects did you have today?
We have now Mongolian, math, and art. Was it cold this morning?
Well, it was okay. Did you freeze on the horse?
Nah, not really.
Okay, see you.
Okay.
The math teacher is waiting. She wants to start on time. Delgertsetseg says her goodbyes to her friends and makes plans to play again.
We play school. Someone is then the teacher, the others are students, and class president.
Now Delgertsetseg must get going again, to the train station, where she has to meet her father. She must cross the tracks again. At lunchtime, there are more trains. Their destination is the capital, 200 kilometers away, Ulaanbaatar. They often only pass through Tunkhel, so the girl has to be extremely careful.
Train. Let's go, come on.
At 1:30, father and daughter are on their way back. They leave the town and head back to her parents' yurt beyond the river, where a thin blanket of snow covered the morning road. Now patches of ice appear. The bike drives over the frozen bed of ice. Aware of the danger of slipping, her father, Dava, does his best to avoid the bare ice. The first hurdle has been overcome. But even if they're tired, father and daughter still have to concentrate. Tuguldur must also concentrate now. The math test has begun. First, the children have to solve dictated math problems openly on a laminated piece of paper. Later, separately in their books.
So, let me see. 77.05. Exactly right.
Delgertsetseg gets a little restless on the bike saddle. She fidgets behind the back of her father, who reminds her to sit quietly.
The dogs are attacking!
Ah!
Go, go! Come on!
Compared to the morning, Delgertsetseg is now boisterous. It's probably the anticipation of tomorrow's spring festival, which has raised her spirits. But before the party can get started, the nomads must finish the final tasks in order to close out the year coming to an end. And like every day right after school, the 12-year-old schoolgirl has to help at home. As the youngest of four children, she learned very early on how to handle a sharp axe by herself. After chopping wood, the work continues. Delgertsetseg has to help her aunt to round up the cows. There is always plenty to do.
On my list, chop the wood, fetch the water, bringing in the wood, sweep, mop the floor, wash the dishes.
But of course, Delgertsetseg would rather play than work. After milking the cows, she hides, much to the displeasure of her father.
Have you fed the calf?
Actually, our youngest is a really hard worker. I don't have to do much. She does everything, brings water and gives the calves water and grass, straightens and cleans up, washes the dishes. She can already do all these tasks.
It's important to the parents to keep the traditional nomadic culture alive. In the celebratory ritual, her aunt sprinkles some of the freshly retrieved milk. Life with nature is a constant give and take for the Mongolians. At school, however, the nomadic children learn everything they need for a modern life, to get jobs in the big city if need be. Tuguldur wants to be a soldier someday. During recess, he practices a little.
During the break, we wrestle. Sometimes we play catch. But mostly, we are wrestling.
Wrestling is a popular sport in Mongolia and allowed by the teachers in the schoolyard. It's about sportsmanship, testing one's strength, and experiencing success. For Tuguldur, who lives far away from his friends, recess is the only time he has to play with his peers.
We have 30 minutes in the big break. We drink and eat in the first 10 minutes, and then we get out. And then I play with my class, about 20 minutes or so. Hello, Manda.
Ah, hello, all right?
Yes, hello.
Is school over?
Yes, done.
School is out at 5 o'clock. Manda, a family friend, helps Tuguldur up on his horse.
Okay, go nice and slow on the way home, all right?
Yes.
On his way home, Tuguldur takes a small detour and rides up to the stupa, a sacred Buddhist place of worship. Perhaps there is something to discover. Sometimes there are interesting offerings there. But his father had warned the boy not to dawdle on the way home, so he doesn't have to ride home in the dark. And at school, they said it would snow in the evening. For the young Mongolian, it's back to the frozen valley of the nomads. The temperature quickly drops to minus 20 degrees Celsius. Going back across the river, he trusts the same location as at noontime. This time, too, Tuguldur gets safely to the other side. But the ride home from school will be more difficult this time. As predicted, snow is falling. In the valley, thick flakes blanket the landscape. On New Year's Eve, a time of year that the nomads yearn for since it symbolizes the beginning of spring. Tuguldur rides a little faster past Delgertsetseg's family's yurts. 5 kilometers left to get home, and Tuguldur must decide.
On the warm horse, you do not freeze that easily. Only if you ride really fast and the wind blows from the front, then you freeze. But if you trot lightly or ride at a walk, then it's okay.
If he rides fast, Brownie might not see a deep hole in dense snowdrifts and could stumble. Should Tuguldur ride slowly, he will get caught in the dark. Tuguldur presses Brownie on. He would rather hurry home. Deep snow drifts have formed in some places, and Brownie is constantly running into them. Tuguldur tries to keep his balance. The boy, who can't even get up onto his horse alone, summons all his courage and rides the last 4 kilometers through the snow-covered steppe as fast as he can. Around 6 o'clock, as the snow subsides, Delgertsetseg and her family scrape the yurts free of snow. It's time to prepare the celebration. The parents have set up a buffet table in the center of the yurt. Pastries, cheeses, sweets, and vodka for the adults are ready to mark the closure of the days of want and to celebrate the new year. As night falls, Tuguldur has just now made it home. Outside the house, his father has been watching out for him.
Well, was it cold?
No.
Was it okay?
Yes.
Good. Go have a look inside. I'll take care of the horse.
While his father, Murun, removes the saddle and gives the horse hay and water, Tuguldur does his homework in excited anticipation. He now has 5 days' holiday and the party.
So, Tsagansa is the Mongolian New Year. It's where the Mongols, that's us, show our elders respect and honor, and welcome all who are older with a welcoming ritual. The children get up very early and then greet their parents, first the father and then the mother. And at the greeting ritual, one should always put something in their hand, a small gift.
The next morning,
every New Year's Day, we go to a place of sacrifice and give the mountain small offerings and look at the sunrise.
Look at it now.
The first rays of the New Year's sun. His father, Murun, soaks it up.
You look at the sunrise in the place of sacrifice because that brings good luck and blessings. Papa and I climb up here every New Year.
Delgertsetseg has put on her best garments for this day and may now enjoy some snacks from the buffet table. Tuguldur, his parents and sister, now visit his grandparents and relatives in the village.
Are you all right?
Are you all right?
The feast is served. On this day, one goes from house to house and wishes their relatives a happy new year. The men exchange flasks of tobacco as a sign of mutual respect. And for nomadic children, it's now time to go outside and enjoy the coming spring. Slowly, the ice and the cold will disappear.